What if I told you that behind some of the biggest, most monumental breakthroughs in medical history was one African-American woman? I guarantee there is not a person watching this video who has not personally benefited from her sacrifice. Her name is Henrietta Lacks, and she was a black mother of five from Baltimore. After her youngest was born in 1950, she knew something was wrong. Henrietta's doctor found a mass on her cervix and sent her to the prestigious Johns Hopkins Hospital for treatment. It was the only place that would treat black patients at the time. Henrietta was diagnosed with cervical cancer and scheduled for surgery. Just before the operation, the gynecology resident collected a routine sample of the tumor without her knowledge or consent. This is before the age of medical privacy laws, and this was pretty standard practice at the time. In spite of treatment, Lacks had a very aggressive form of cancer, and within a few months, she was dead, just 31 years old, leaving behind a husband and five very young children. She also left behind those tumor cells in the hospital lab. It just so happened that there was a husband and wife team of researchers called Margaret and George Guy at Johns Hopkins who had been in that lab for 30 years. And they were trying to figure out how to get human cells to live and reproduce so they could be studied. It's hard to imagine, but this is before the age of tissue culturing. Nobody had managed to figure that out yet. And that's because human cells don't like to live outside the body. It's pretty hard to keep them around, let alone have them multiply so that you can use them for research. But the cells removed from Lacks were radically different. Her tumor cells not only lived in the lab, they reproduced like crazy. To this day, nobody knows why. But the guys had discovered the first line of immortal human cells. They named them HeLa cells. Word spread, and soon George Guy was shipping HeLa cells around the world for research. Like I said, they've been used in some of the most important medical breakthroughs of our time, including gene mapping. They were even launched into outer space to see how human cells would behave in zero gravity. But while all this research was going on, two incredibly significant problems were brewing. The first was the fact that the family of Henrietta Lacks had no idea that her cells were being mass-produced and studied around the world. What's more, they were being sold for profit by pharmaceutical companies who'd obtained them from the Johns Hopkins lab. The Lacks family was completely in the dark about this, not receiving any recognition, let alone a single dime in compensation. All around the country, biology professors were teaching their students about these HeLa cells. Researchers were using them for important studies and scientific breakthroughs. But exactly who'd produced these immortal cells had become something of an urban legend. Henrietta's name had been abbreviated for convenience and privacy, and HeLa cells came to be attributed to a mysterious woman named Helen Lane. It took a chance encounter in a public restroom of all places to uncover the true source of these incredible cells. In 1974, a guy called Michael Rogers happened upon a strange bit of graffiti in a San Francisco Medical Library bathroom. There, above the urinal, was scrawled the words, "Helen Lane lives." He didn't think much of it at the time. But because there's no such thing as coincidence, as far as I'm concerned, Rogers ran across the name again a couple of months later, this time in the pages of the journal Science. The article revealed that Helen Lane was the woman behind HeLa cells. It also detailed the second major problem of our story, that the mismanagement of HeLa cells stood to become one of the greatest disasters in the history of medical research. You see, these same cells that fueled momentous medical discovery were apparently so aggressive and pervasive that they'd managed to infiltrate labs around the world, hitchhiking their way into study after study, secretly sabotaging data for over two decades. You can imagine, it's not hard for a tiny cell to be transferred via a piece of lab equipment or through a ventilation system from one experiment to another, which has almost unimaginable repercussions. You think that you're studying lung cells or kidney cells, for example, when you're really studying cervical tumor cells. And you have no way of knowing that all of your data, findings you're publishing, having peer-reviewed data that are the basis of new medical treatments and drugs, becoming a part of the canon of accepted scientific knowledge. And it's all built upon a mistake that can't even be identified, let alone measured. When this shattering revelation about contamination came out in Science, it set off a firestorm that may never be resolved. The problem is actually much bigger. We're talking about tens of thousands of medical studies published in prestigious journals. And those studies, cited by at least half a million additional studies, adding up to hundreds of millions of dollars in compromised medical research. It is a clusterfuck, which brings us back to the dishonor being done for decades to the family of Henrietta Lacks. To manage this crisis, John Hopkins contacted members of the Lacks family to collect blood samples, which they said was for more research. The real reason they needed the blood was so they could map the family's genome. That way, labs around the world could investigate whether their cultured tissue was contaminated with HeLa cells. Still on the trail, Michael Rogers tracked down the family of Henrietta Lacks and chronicled the saga of the HeLa cells, disclosing Helen Lane's true identity in an article for Rolling Stone in 1976. The woman behind HeLa was at long last revealed, but that didn't mean her family would finally be compensated. They wouldn't even be properly acknowledged for another 40 years, after author Rebecca Skloot collaborated with Henrietta's daughter, Deborah, to finally tell this story. I think Oprah even made a movie about it. Thanks to the awareness raised, Lacks family representatives now have a say in how the NIH uses HeLa cells for research. But make no mistake, knowing the source of HeLa hasn't solved the scientific research conundrum, nor has it compensated the Lacks family for their matriarch's sacrifice. That's because the pharmaceutical companies that have made insane profits off of HeLa cells don't feel any responsibility to pay for what they got. There's a shocker. These companies allege that even after they knew Henrietta's identity, they didn't want to compromise her privacy and weren't obligated to pay or compensate the Lacks family. In 2021, the estate of Henrietta Lacks filed a lawsuit against the pharmaceutical company Thermo Fisher Scientific. An estimated $250 billion in profits were on the line. The suit was settled, but the terms remained a secret. Over 70,000 published studies, 55 million tons of tissue, enough cells to wrap around the Earth three times. It's almost impossible to imagine, given how minuscule a human cell is, that you can fit about 40,000 of them on the head of a pin. So many cells, so many experiments, so many breakthroughs, and so much owed to the sacrifice of one woman. Her name was Henrietta Lacks. Thank you so much for watching this episode. Please support our mission to shine a light on the flip side of history by liking, subscribing, and sharing this video, and please comment on it if you can. Until next time, I'm Faust Teacher reminding you to question the answers.